I gotta play them all.
Someone on the Ramen Train! Hello everyone, welcome back to Genshin Impact. So I have pretty much finished up Sarah's Sumera compilation. So let's celebrate by doing Layla's Hangout quest. Now, I'm gonna be honest, I was gonna build up Layla, but seeing as how I have so many goddamn units to focus on, I just gave up in the end. But regardless, let's do Layla's story Hangout event. Ever silent stars. Yeah. So hopefully once I'm done with this, I'll probably get to work on like a few smaller videos and then get to work on Sarah's Fontaine compilation. Are you a student here?
I may not be for long. Anyway, I'm Layla. I'm a Talahis student at the academia. Well, for now, at least. I was just looking up some information at the House of Dana. But the more I read, the more I realized that my thesis lacks integrity. I didn't cover many of the possible outliers and calculations aren't precise enough.
Aw. Being long tortured by her own anxiety, anxious thoughts, Layla's stress value shows her current mental state. This value will fluctuate as the story progresses. Appraise the situation carefully before making your choice. Ooh. Okay, so what are you planning to do now?
Well, I guess I have to keep looking up as much info as possible. I shouldn't give up now. But who am I kidding? Maybe I'm not cut out to be a researcher. Maybe I shouldn't have come to the academia in the first place. All I've done is cause trouble for my advisor and classmates.
Cheer up! Things probably aren't as bad as you think they are.
To be honest, I haven't slept a wink for days. Just thinking about the awful state of my thesis keeps me up at night. Lack of sleep hinders my ability to focus, and if I can't focus, I can't do any proper research or thinking.
Are they a sage?
If that was the case, I would have already left on my own. Just the idea of being watched by a sage is terrifying. This might sound strange, but I actually don't know who's been helping me. I don't even know if they're a person or not. Due to my lack of sleep, I sometimes get dizzy and faint when I'm stressed out.
It's that bad, huh?
Yeah, but oddly enough, when I wake up, all the things I was stressing over are taken care of. My homework's somehow finished before the deadline, and my papers are perfectly written. But that's not all. My flowers are watered, laundry's done, even my broken kitchen.
That sounds pretty extraordinary.
But there's no point in me studying at the academia if I keep relying on this mysterious phenomenon. It comes down to my own efforts, improving one step at a time. How else can I honor my parents and live up to the expectations of everyone who knows me?
That makes sense. The effort you put in is equally important.
Oh no, I've already spent too much time chatting. I still haven't made much headway on my thesis. At this rate, I'll need the Wisdom Seelie's help.
You said you wanted to rely on your own efforts. Can Seelies even do something like that?
No one knows who or what it actually is. It's just known as the Wisdom Seelie.
I mean, kinda makes sense. Seelies are mysterious.
But getting an answer all comes down to the Seelie's mood. Sometimes it'll only give you a vague answer or play tricks on you. I'm pretty sure a researcher wouldn't do something like that.
That's very odd.
All I can do right now is hope that it helps me.
But what about the blessing from the stars?
Who knows if it'll happen this time? I can't put all my eggs in one basket. Trying my luck with another phenomenon is better than doing nothing.
It sounds a little sketchy, but I'll go check it out with you.
Oh, really? But I don't want to take up your time.
It's fine, I don't have anything going on.
Sorry for the bother. You're too kind. Okay, let's go give it a try. I've already prepared my question for the Seelie. I just hope it can help me get through this predicament. Among the countless legends surrounding the House of Dana, the Wisdom Seelie is one of the more popular ones lately. It hasn't been around for long, but word of the Seelie's existence spread like wildfire. Many people have claimed that they've received a reply from it. So, it should probably help me as well, right?
So, do you just call its name and it appears?
I don't know its name, and we have to keep our voices down in the House of Dana. Or else you'll get some scary glares from the Mahamada. Let's split up and ask around about the Seelie. Hopefully someone knows something more.
Yeah, hopefully I'll be done with, I'll be all caught up with Sarah's compilation work, and then I want to get to work on an Inazuma Culture Shock video, which I know has been, like, long overdue.
That sounds like what others have said, but I don't have the time to wait for a reply if the Seelie doesn't answer right away. Whatever. Can
Layla placed her letter in the designated book.
I wrote out my question and put it in the book.
What do we do now?
Wait, I guess. Let's give it some time. I'll come back tomorrow to check on it. Don't worry about me if you have other things to do.
I'll come with you. I'm a little worried. The next day, you wait and turn to that same bookshelf.
Time to look at the letter. Please let there be a stamp. Please let there be a stamp.
Oh my god, she has the Triforce on the back of her hood.
There's a red stamp on it. The Sealy responded. Fantastic.
Your eyes are sparkly. Oh, what?
This is wonderful.
Oh, is that good? What?
Questionable motives? Me? Wait, huh? Okay, let's see. Completing the thesis requires independent thought and work. You planned on using my knowledge to complete your paper's most critical portions. That's not right. However, considering that your deadline is fast approaching, and that there is substance to the content in the completed sections of your thesis, I've decided to help you nonetheless. Follow the hints I've left, and you will find the answer to your question. Consider the effort you put into thinking and searching as your payment for my knowledge. What the...
Aww. I'll search for the answer. I'll search for the answers with you.
I could tell you're a very kind person, but I never expected that you'd go this far to help me. I'll definitely think of a way to make it up to you once I take care of my thesis.
Now don't worry about it. It's just another day in the life of an adventurer. Wisdom is probably referring to the academia.
Possibly. That sounds like a natural conclusion. So, is the road of wisdom the road that leads to the academia? Wait, I think I get what it means by the child and awe and fear. When I first left home, it took me days to reach Sumeru City. Oh, I was completely shocked when I first saw it with my own eyes. It was so grand and awe-inspiring. Pictures of the city simply don't do it any justice. After seeing the city, a thought popped into my head. Am I really worthy of this place?
Sorry about that. Dusting. hangout event's not too important. And that's the fear? Maybe I wasn't referring to you specifically.
You have a point. There's nothing special about my background or experiences. It could be anyone's. Anyway, let's go take a look.
Multitasking. Wait, where exactly are we supposed to... We're supposed to go here? Isn't there a Fatui camp over there? Are we gonna go meet some Ara-Ara? Aran-Aran? Feels like it. Pretty big area.
It is. Relying solely on what the silly said might not be viable. Assuming the silly is intentionally linking the clues to my past, I think I have an idea.
Let's hear it. Price of being distracted.
I didn't notice it at all. Oh, the poor thing was sound asleep, and after I stepped on its tail, it bolted straight up. I freaked out and ran as fast as I could. There were actually more Avidia leopards sleeping nearby, and they were all faster than me. I almost got bitten a couple of times. Good thing someone from the Aramites heard me shouting for help. They managed to scare off the leopards.
Oh, relatable. Good thing you weren't hurt.
Yeah, but when I finally managed to calm myself down, I noticed that the talisman my mother had made for me was missing. It's extremely precious to me. Ever since I was little, I would always carry it with me whenever I'm doing something important. I also had it with me when the academia conducted its selection exam at my village. I checked my bag at least a dozen times to make sure the talisman was in there. I feel much more at ease knowing that I have it with me. I had thought that it would also help me calm my nerves in Sumeru City. But I ended up losing it before I even finished registration at the academia.
I can sympathize with your feeling of loss.
Yeah, and that's when I started having sleeping problems. I just began to sleep less and less each day. Losing a talisman like that is definitely a bad omen. What were we talking about before? All right. Why the silly led us here? I think we should look around.
Let's look around first. It seems like the Silly knows you really well.
I don't know, but how did it know about all these details? I've hardly told anyone about this stuff. It's not hiding somewhere and spying on me, is it? Oh, that's a scary thought. Anyway, let's look at the clue we found.
This might be too much, even for the Wisdom Sealy. You already got the meaning?
If the first clue was any indication, then the location described in this clue should also be related to my life experiences. Most Ritawahist research is related to studying the stars. My own thesis work often requires me to go in the field and collect astrological data. Another devastating and unforgettable failure I had.
Thinking about these things will only make things worse for you.
But that can't be helped, right? We do many things not because we want to, but because we have to. Let's keep moving. It might be hard to believe, but being out and about is making me feel a lot better.
Before we go, let me mine all this stuff up.
A walk would be nice.
I need those minerals. Isn't there sweet flower over here? No.
Ready to
We're all prone to make mistakes when we aren't real. Well, we're all prone to mistakes when we aren't well rested. So what happened afterwards? Were you injured?
I just got a minor fracture, so I had to rest up in Marston for a while. To pay off the damages to the equipment, I took some part-time jobs. I just went to work whenever I couldn't sleep. It took me forever to pay off what I owed.
Don't tell me your insomnia got worse after that. Aww.
After all, I am the legendary Layla who made it into the academia at a young age. Aww, and had never failed an assignment in her life.
Ever consider taking a break?
Of course. I've even considered giving up on my studies completely and returning home to help care for the Sumter Beast, but that would be kind of embarrassing.
That's not the break I meant. Your parents would feel bad if they knew what you were going through.
And that's exactly why they mustn't ever find out. Once I finally manage to acclimate to life in Sumeru City, I'll show them my success. Oh, I hope that day will come eventually. Anyways, let's continue looking for the next clue. It should be around here soon.
Got away. Have to go diving down. Ah, shit. Come on, Mona, you can do it! Oh, come on! Give me the fireflies. Give me the fireflies.
Give me the fireflies.
Okay. It feels like the clues are getting more and more vague. Sounds like this is getting personal.
Would someone really go to all this trouble just to pull off some prank? I can't make heads or tails of it. Anyway, just follow me. I'll save the story for when we get there.
So I've already got that one. So you wanted to help, but couldn't. Then what happened?
I could have stepped in to help that family. Would it have ended differently if I were just a little briefer?
You did the right thing.
Aww,
Let's take a break from searching and rest for a bit. Your health is more important than your thesis.
Aww. Sorry for causing you so much trouble.
Let's find some place to rest.
Alright. I actually don't have much stamina. I've been stressed this whole time, and I feel exhausted. I'm really sorry.
Jesus Christ.
Let's stop here. I don't think I can walk any further.
I'll prepare some food and juice. No, you shouldn't say that.
I'm sorry. I always find myself having to apologize. But enough of that. I need to pull myself together. The memories I've been reminded of are all really taxing. I cannot just give up this time, even if my head's not in a good place.
What's wrong?
Behind you.
It's slimes, aren't they? Just leave it to me. It'll only take a moment.
No, I'll fight too.
You need to rest. I see.
Alright, let's take them all down.
Shadows of fate. Too late for it, right? Dare to mess with me. We'll see about that.
Alright, let's see Layla. All these characters seem to have Noblesse Oblige. Favonius Sword, okay. Oh god, more! Even more.
Delve into destiny. Stars shine for you. Dare to mess with me.
Are you all right? You did great.
Thanks for the compliment. I sure don't get to hear that often. Although I may not be physically strong, my will is as resilient as they come. I'll be fine after I rest for a bit. Can you stay with me while I recover my energy? It shouldn't take long.
Once bitten, twice shy. Despite her incredible weak disposition, she still chose to make a stand. Perhaps she wanted to prove a point, or perhaps she didn't want to leave regrets. Alright. That was nice. On to the next one. It might be messing with you.
Good point. Why else would it use such a roundabout way to tell me its answer? Supposedly, everyone who's been pranked by the silly had angered it in some way. That means the silly is someone who's very strict and serious about knowledge. But who knows if it's really a silly.
The main issue is that you have a deadline to meet.
True. And if I don't get an answer, then I'll only have wasted more time. But there's nothing else we can do. It's the one holding all the cards. It's completely hidden and can choose whether to help us or not. After all, it'd probably be impossible to find it and ask my question in person.
Now that sounds like an idea.
I was just kidding. Please don't take me seriously. It's a silly we're talking about. According to legend, sillies are elusive and can create countless copies of themselves. Who's to say that it won't summon a shooting star to crush us once we find it?
You don't actually believe in those legends, do you? Think about what you just said for a moment.
Sorry, I'm just a little panicky. Okay, Layla, calm down and think. If the silly is a person, then there has to be a way to track them down. We have two possible leads right now. The first is the checkout logs of those two books, and the other is the red stamp. The red stamp bears the Ritualist emblem, which is used by a lot of people. It'll be hard to track down an individual, so we should probably start with the checkout logs.
Can't disagree with that logic. It sounds like some hero out of a fairy tale.
Well, it is a legend after all. It's no surprise that some details seem a little exaggerated. But these aren't just made up, you know. Each of its abilities has been confirmed by eyewitnesses. There have been many sightings too, including a Chetrakon cave, the Avidia forest, and around the waterfall south of Sumeru City.
Has anyone seen what it actually looks like? Or what kind of person it is?
Not that I know of. No one's been able to get close to it. It seems like it tries to stay out of sight. I would probably want to remain a mystery too, if I were someone as legendary as the Wisdom Sealy. So what do you make of it? Have you seen it somewhere as well?
No. We're probably gonna need some time to digest all the, incredible information you've provided us.
Not a problem. But if you manage to find anything, be sure to come and tell me about it. I trust that you'll quickly discover the excitement of slowly unraveling the truth.
Then why didn't you just say so?
Logically, that has nothing to do with the question I asked. I just don't want others to see me as some poor excuse for a student whiling away my time in the House of Dana.
I don't really think bad students would come to the House of Dana to pass the time. But anyways, you were saying?
Well, I spend most of my time here, and I have noticed something odd before. One time, late at night, a black shadow fell from above and landed in the central area of the House of Dana. Of course, I was a little sleepy at the time, but it startled me, and I got up to see what was going on.
And then what happened?
Then, the shadow quickly circled behind me with incredible speed. Just as I tried to turn around to get a look at it, I fainted.
This shadow sounds pretty powerful.
Yes, it was unbelievably fast. I had never seen anything like it. It was so unusual that I wasn't sure if it was real or if I was half dreaming. But given how popular the Legend of the Sealy has become lately, maybe this has something to do with it.
Don't take this the wrong way, but doesn't the House of Dana have a door?
It was closed that night. I suppose even the House of Dana needs to be closed for maintenance from time to time.
I see. That makes sense. But what were you doing here if the House of Dana was closed?
Don't look so surprised. It's a common practice to find a place to hide before they lock the doors, so you can continue reading books here. Everyone knows that.
Good thing I'm not studying alongside you. I can tell that you'd really stress me out.
Checkout logs for
scratch my inventory records, it would come to my attention immediately. However, it might be possible to pull off in the case of a less popular book.
Okay, I understand now, thank you. This is useful to know. With any luck, it'll help us work out the Sealy's identity. Okay, everyone's given us a lot of useful information. Let's go through it and try to organize everything. Some things we heard were pretty straightforward, but others were just, ridiculous.
We should be able to figure out more about its identities and whereabouts. So what you've come up with?
First, based on the information Kata Yun provided, we can assume that the Sealy is a student from the Ritawa Darshan. The possibility of it being someone outside the Darshan can be ruled out because it'd be impossible to gain access to those two books without going through the librarian. Next, leaving its crazy abilities aside, all the sightings took place in locations that are officially recommended for astrology observation by the academia. In other words, it's probably just conducting research, and the nature of its research is very similar to mine.
It's her. Your reasoning is solid.
It's nothing, really. There are actually some other factors that I've been speculating about. But that's not important right now. Let's get going. Even though we have a lead, it's still hard to say whether we'll be able to make any discoveries. I'll tell you what I mean by that if the Sealy doesn't show up.
I'll stay up with you. Are you referring to the Wisdom Seal or the Blessing from the Stars? What if I could help you? Seeing how badly she wants to know, maybe we should find a way to ask about the other Layla about it. Oh, nothing. There really isn't anything we can do. Seems like we've come up empty-handed again this time. There's nothing else I could do. I'm sorry.
Please stop. The more you talk about it, the more silly I feel. Oh, come on, Layla. What are you doing? Everyone's gonna start thinking you're crazy now. Oh no. I'm losing it. Oh, so dizzy.
I'm sorry to have made you feel so uncomfortable. Seems like she's completely recovered, huh? Huh? Does that mean...
Oh, what's wrong? You look like you've got something on your mind.
Are you the other Layla?
Hmm? What are you talking about? What do you mean the other Layla? I am Layla.
But you somehow seem a little different. I'm a friend of Layla's. I'm trying to help her finish her thesis.
Let me think. Okay, I got it. You two found this place by following the hints that I left behind. You were planning to wait for me. Or I should say, you were waiting for the Sealy to show up. Was this your idea or hers?
Mostly hers. Did you infiltrate the house of Dina? And what about those rumors of special powers? You're the Seelie, aren't you?
That's right. Though I didn't intend for it to turn out this way, really. I just wanted to help out a few other classmates who were having a hard time while I was helping Layla finish her thesis. You see, Layla doesn't have many friends at the academia. If the others noticed her helping them out, I thought maybe I'd help her become more sociable. Unfortunately, that didn't really work out. Instead, legends of the Seelie started going around. But that's alright.
What's with the Seelie pranking people?
I can instantly tell which students are asking serious questions and which are just trying to take advantage of me to slack off. My time to move freely is quite limited, so it's only natural that I would punish the people attempting to waste my time. My intention is to help people. I'm not here to cause any harm. Well then, does that answer all your questions?
Actually, I have one last question. Why don't you want her to know you exist?
You see, her emotions are incredibly unstable. She's constantly doubting herself. If she knew that there's another Layla who is capable of doing everything, she might think even less of herself. She could think, maybe I should just leave it all to her. I'm always relying on her anyway. Why not let her live my life for me? She might start thinking about giving up completely, and that's the exact opposite of what I'm trying to do for her. After all, she and I are one and the same. We're two sides of the same coin. No one knows her greatest strength more than I do. It's her resilience. If she's able to persevere in everything she does, then one day she won't need my help anymore. I trust that she's capable of doing that, and it's something that she should do on her own.
I see.
She actually discovered the key data she needs for her thesis a long time ago. She just didn't organize it well enough. I'll complete her thesis for her just as I have in the past. Oh, please don't share any of this with her. I would like to keep this a secret for both of our sakes.
I understand. You're fine. You just had a little nap.
Oh, I see. Was I sleepwalking? I was, wasn't I?
Nope.
Really? I don't believe you. You're hiding something from me. It's written all over your face.
I'm not, really. That which remains unspoken, to keep a promise made to her, means the breaking of a promise made to her. This is a tricky situation indeed. Alright, what will be next? Alright, I'm back. Sorry, I had to take care of some things. Anyways, the Sealy probably wants to do more than just criticize you for the past. Why don't you try facing your challenge head on?
It's a picture?
So it's not a riddle this time.
Guess not. This house looks like it's in Vimara Village. Does the Sealy want us to go there?
This might be the last stop in our search. Just be sure not to push yourself too hard.
Thanks, but I'm fine. I'm used to pushing my limits. I know how far I can go.
Should be a bridge somewhere, right? No. In there.
Let's see. This should be the place. Nothing seems out of the ordinary. Maybe the Sealy didn't prepare anything for us this time. Or does it want us to knock on the door first?
Calm down.
You're right. I can't always be like this. Sometimes it's better to take action than overthink every little thing.
What's going on, Layla?
I don't know either. I don't even know where to begin. I recognized him immediately. He's one of the people that was getting robbed by the treasure hoarders. But he shouldn't know anything about me. He shouldn't even know who I am.
You said you've been to Vimara Village once.
This is the talisman that I lost, the one that my mother made for me.
What the? Isn't it really this? Is it really the same one you lost?
Yes, this is definitely it. She made it herself. It's the only one of its kind. There's also a letter here. Was I planning to send it to someone? Let's see who the recipient is. To Layla?
I'm assuming you aren't in the habit of writing letters to yourself.
No. I swear I've never done anything like that. What is going on? Let's open it and see what this is all about. Hello, Layla. It must have been quite the endeavor to follow the Seelie's hints all the way here. Great work. Self-reflection is a wonderful quality to possess,
it be that the wisdom sealy is you?
I doubt it. I mean, unless I somehow came here while I was unconscious and don't remember it. Although, having said that, I have heard rumors claiming that I sleepwalk a lot. But even then, that doesn't necessarily mean that I'm actually the wisdom sealy. It could have just helped me while I was sleepwalking.
Either way, it's safe to say that it's related to the blessing from the stars.
I'll write back and ask to meet with the sealy and see how it responds. Even though I still have a lot of questions, this experience was fruitful enough. If it wasn't for your encouragement, I probably would have quit halfway through and holed up in the academia somewhere. Perseverance really does pay off.
I'm not sure if I understand what has happened, but it's something good, right?
Yes, it's something really, really good, and I'm very thankful for it.
Well then, since you're already here, why don't you stay and have something to eat? We just finished preparing some food. Come on, don't be a stranger. Your friend should join us as well. You can leave your troubles until after the meal. You must relax and gather your strength so you can take on the challenges ahead. Am I right?
He's right. Aw. That's really nice. The price to pay and its returns. I wish you courage as you carry onward and hope that you fulfill the expectations you hold. It's too risky to rely on some fishy legend to complete your thesis.
You're right. I need to keep a level head. I don't have time to waste. But what do we do from here? I can't just go back and start packing to leave.
You should rest first. You won't be able to write anything in your current state.
You do have a point. Oh, sorry. I tend to panic easily, as you can see. Then how should I rest? I definitely won't be able to sleep. As soon as I close my eyes, all kinds of thoughts start floating into my head.
How about we head to Puspa Cafe?
Oh, that's a good idea. A cup of coffee might help clear my head. Let's go.
Sorry, but who are you?
I'm one of Layla's classmates. I just came by to say hi. We just submitted our theses and we're totally beat. Everyone will be meeting here to celebrate. Seeing how relaxed you look, you must have already had your thesis finished ages ago.
Oh, no, I'm actually having a lot of trouble with it.
You say that every time we talk, but you've never missed a deadline. Not only that, your papers are always well written and
What are you getting at?
For starters, she doesn't even try to participate with the group at all. It's one thing that she's not willing to help us, but she doesn't even bother showing up for our discussion meetings. Every time we come to see her, she looks out of sorts and on the verge of a breakdown. It's not like we can't finish our own theses without her, but no one wants to always see her this way.
Everyone is entitled to their own choice. You should learn to respect that.
Whatever. There's no point in starting an argument here. If you think she can justify her behavior, then that's your opinion.
Thanks for standing up for me. I really want to help the others, but most of the time I'm barely scraping by myself. There's very little I can help with.
Is it because you don't want others to know about the blessing from the stars?
Yeah, I can't ever tell my classmates about that. I'd be a mess if they ever reported it to my advisor. It's really just a big misunderstanding, and there's nothing I can do about it. Everyone just gives me weird looks and judges me. It's making it really difficult to find friends.
I think I understand your situation now.
What do you mean?
You think that the blessing from the stars is some external power that's out of your control?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Seems you know just as well as I do. The thing is, I'm terrible under pressure. That's just my nature. Even the thought of everyone's expectations back home is enough to make me feel nervous. And the more nervous I get, the worse things become around me. Take what Munira just said, for example. I don't think I'll be able to get it out of my mind for the entire day. That means I won't be able to relax at all today.
Why don't we try facing the problem head on? It's simple. Just break down the unfinished parts of the thesis into different tasks and tackle them one by one.
Okay. I've got a pen and paper with me. Let me go through them real quick. The theory sections are pretty much finished. I'll be able to finish organizing the rest of my own. As of now, I'm missing crucial observation data. I need the results of an observation to validate the conclusion of my thesis. And then there's the preparation for my thesis defense. I'll need to mentally prepare.
Those don't sound too difficult. I can help you.
What? You want to help me with my thesis? Thank you. Thank you so much. I don't even know how to show you my gratitude.
Don't worry about it. We've already come this far.
You're so kind. I had no idea I'd meet someone so nice in Sumeru City. Okay, I'll do my best. It's the least I can do, considering everything you've already done for me. First on the list is the experiment to get observational data. I actually had it all planned out several days ago and even borrowed a celestial globe from a Makamata. However, the weather was rainy every single day after I borrowed it, and I was unable to compare the night sky against the celestial globe. There were a lot of people waiting to borrow the celestial globe, and I wasn't able to extend my time slot, so I returned it and haven't been able to borrow it again since. That's why I still haven't performed the necessary observations yet. I don't know what to do.
So you're lacking some equipment.
That's right. The Celestial Globe is a high-precision device used specifically for researching the stars. Submitting an application to borrow one from the Academia is pretty much
Looks like we're gonna have to ask around at the Adventurers Guild.
Huh? Why the Adventurers Guild?
Because no one has a network like Catherine does.
Oh, I see. The Adventurers Guild is open to everyone's commission, so she might have some ideas. Okay, let's go and try our luck.
We would like to borrow a high-precision Celestia globe.
Right. Equipment at the Academia is in very high demand, and we aren't able to borrow one now. We were hoping someone else might have something similar that we could use.
I don't know anything about astrology, so I'm afraid I'm unfamiliar with the device you are looking for. However, one of our requesters happens to be an astrology enthusiast. I hear that he's a collector of all sorts of specialized astrology equipment. After the Adventurers Guild helped him out, he indicated that he'd be happy to return the favor if the adventurers ever need it. Perhaps we could arrange a meeting between you two. That should help solve your problem.
Really?
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. It's my job to provide adventurers with the necessary support. The man's name is Azam. Here's his address. You can go ahead and pay him a visit. Explain to Azam the purpose of your visit.
Ah, I see. Well, if it's a request from an adventurer, then I'll be happy to help you. I just so happen to have the device that you're looking for. Let me fetch it and show you, just to be sure.
Yes, this is it. Thank you so much. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. I just got a little excited. Please go ahead.
To be honest, judging by what stands before me, I find it very hard to believe that you're an astute Rotawa student.
Well...
Astrology is a hobby of mine, and these devices have cost me both time and mora to collect. I cherish them as if they were members of my own family, which is why I don't let just anyone borrow them on a whim. These devices are delicate and can easily be damaged if used inappropriately.
That's completely understandable. What can I do to better gain your trust?
How about this? I don't need a deposit or anything, but I'd like you to share the contents of your research with me. I'll ask you some questions. If your explanation proves satisfactory, then I'll lend you the device.
Share the contents of my research? And answer questions?
Don't be nervous. Just explain what you've learned.
Alright, I'll try. But I can't disclose the actual details to you. How about a general overview of the research? Would that suffice?
Yes, that would be fine.
You're probably aware that astrologists rely on the movements of celestial bodies to calculate the past and the future, as well as attempt to summarize the correlating principles, correct?
I didn't really understand what you were talking about, but I thought you did great.
Really? I was just explaining what it is I'm trying to do.
You're starting to show signs of becoming a great researcher.
Really? I don't know if you really mean it, but I'm happy to hear that. I guess even the hardest problems can be solved as long as I'm willing to try. Recording and comparing data will be much easier now that we have this device. I can do it all on my own, too. Well, let's continue with the plan. Can you help me with the rehearsal of my thesis defense? We can do that at the House of Dina.
Just tell the heck. Why did it just teleport me here? Why couldn't it just teleport me inside? So I'm playing the role of an academic advisor, right?
That's right. You should have gotten the gist of the content of my thesis when I was explaining it earlier. So ask away. It's okay if your questions are a little off. I'll still treat them as real questions from an advisor and answer seriously.
Got it. You ready? Can you briefly describe the application of the law of triple orbit shift calculation?
Sure. The direction of this research is based on the results of previous research. It's about the feasibility of applying my methodologies to the remaining triple orbit problems. Based on a sample size of 124 cases, we could only achieve approximately 60% accuracy. The results were not reliable enough to be implemented as a law. You can
Despite a few stumblings here and there, Layla manages successfully. Your presentation could use some work, but I can tell that your logic is sound.
Oh, really? You mean it? Then this practice must be helping. During my first thesis defense, I stood like a statue on the stage and my palms were covered in sweat. I couldn't get a single word out.
It seems we've managed to address all the major challenges for you. You worked hard to reach this point. You don't need to rely on others anymore.
I'm not sure how to put this. I'm really happy about everything that's happened, but I'm also feeling a little sad. I still don't know anything about the blessing from the stars. Will it never happen again since I don't need its help anymore? That somehow makes me feel a little... Lonely? Yeah, it almost makes the blessing feel like it was just a tool used for my studies, no? But I would really like to discover what the blessing actually is, if I ever get the chance. I want to express my gratitude for it, or better yet, maybe we could be friends. That's basically how I feel about it. Even if I know nothing about the blessing, I could still feel its companionship all along. It's almost like how you helped me. I really cherish and appreciate it. After all, it wouldn't be right to take such blessings for granted in our lives.
I'm sure it will also be very happy to know you feel this way. Aww. A matter of course. Natural yet incredible, the unfolding of events will be etched in her memories for a long time to come. Aww. Alright. Do you know about the Great Machine?
No. What is that? Is this something that I didn't prepare for at all? You've got to be joking. About this question, I'm sorry. I'm not feeling very well. Everything is spinning.
Are you okay? Oh man.
I'm sorry. I haven't been sleeping very well lately. I tend to get dizzy from time to time, but don't worry, I'm fine now. What's wrong?
I'm waiting for you to answer my question. I don't think it's an issue of whether or not you heard me.
Alright. I guess the cat's out of the bag. Of all the times to wake up. You're Layla's friend, right? And from the looks of things, the two of you are preparing for her thesis events?
Yep, and you must be the blessing from the stars.
However, her
Well, she's finally decided to face the problems with her thesis head on, and she's working very hard on it. Why is that?
Well, she's always been in a fragile state. If she knew that there was another Layla who's always taking care of everything, she might feel like everything she's ever worked for is pointless, and that could lead to some demoralizing thoughts. She's a resilient girl, but no matter how resilient she may be, no one can hold up to criticism and torment from themselves. If her condition grows any worse, it's possible that I might cease to exist as well. Then there wouldn't be anyone to help her.
But she's not doing very well now, either.
She's getting better, though, isn't she? It's apparent how hard she's working now. She's my source of knowledge. I'm merely the representation of how she would be if she were rested and healthy. I believe that she's one of the best, even in a place like the academia where geniuses come by the handful. But growth is a process and shouldn't be rushed. I will always believe in and support her.
It's good that she has you, or she might have already hit rock bottom. Oh, the star's expectations. They will never meet, but she will always walk alongside her. Only by improving yourself and no longer relying on an external power can you break out of the vicious cycle. Sounds like we need to find a way for you to completely relax. Academics are only one part of life. Since you're from the countryside, why don't we leave Samara's city and go sightseeing?
Sightseeing? That does sound pretty nice. I haven't set foot outside the academia in quite a while. I used to enjoy visiting the rainforest, but it's been a while since I've been there. Maybe a lot has changed. Okay, why don't we go there and take a look?
Thank you. Your state of mind is just as important as efficiency if you want to solve the problems that you're facing. What did you usually do as a kid?
I had a bunch of friends back then, and we would go pick wild berries in the woods. No matter what ingredients we found, we would cook them over a fire, and whoever lost one of our games would have to eat all of it.
That sounds a little intense. Why don't we go find something to grill as well?
Sure. I haven't done that in ages. Let's go. Apples and zaytun peaches were the most popular fruits back then. And of course, grilled fish is delicious too. A fish skin releases oils while cooking, which drip into the fire and cause it to burn even brighter.
You bitch! Let me go. Alright, now we gotta mine all this stuff up.
Hurry up.
should be minerals. Make a fire with Layla. Enjoy the delicious food.
Fresh food is the best. I feel like I've traveled back in time. We all used to run around in the woods when we were kids. Trees and mud was the world we knew best. It doesn't matter how long I'm away from the forest. I won't ever forget the feeling of running through the trees. How about you? Can you relate to that feeling? It's almost like not knowing the world will change or ever expecting it to change.
I'm afraid not. I'm an adventurer after all. Although adventurers rarely ever stay in one place. I hope I can experience that feeling one day.
Whatever the case, it's a very warm feeling. In the end, I passed the admissions exam, and the life I had led came to an abrupt end. Later, as I sat in a lecture at the academia, my mind started to wander and I began to think about home. It was then that I realized how long it had been since I went back. I can't go back anymore. And other similar thoughts started to come to mind. I guess I'm still not used to being in the academia yet.
There is a purpose for every stage in life. Everything will get better. I know you can do it.
I'll take the compliment. A little bit of sugar and a good view really go a long way for relaxation. I thought it'd be impossible for me to enjoy something like this. I thought I'd never be able to get my mind off my thesis. But now, I feel like I'm fully enjoying myself. It's really great. So, what are we doing next?
Sometimes you don't need a plan. It's just nice to stroll around and see what happens.
You're right. I've been doing research for so long that I'm used to having a certain routine. A carefree stroll. I like the sound of that.
Oh God! Let's get out of here. God, what is it now? Okay, I think we finished up. Sorry about that. It's another goddamn world quest. Why don't we just go for a swim?
A swim? I can't remember the last time I went swimming. I might not even know how to anymore.
It's one of those things that you never forget. Let's see who can get there first. I'm extremely worried that Paimon's gonna show up and screw everything. I was worried that you would drown. Really are too modest.
Please, you're always encouraging me. I'm starting to feel embarrassed. But swimming again really feels great. Every muscle in my body was engaged. I probably wouldn't have to worry about my thesis if I turned into a fish, don't you think? I'm just kidding, of course. I'm sure fish have worries of their own. I'm quite content with how things are right now. Let's keep going, shall we? There's a mushroom here. You want to jump on it to see what's up there? I haven't done this in a while.
That's why I said that your life shouldn't completely revolve around your studies. Would you like to take the opportunity to release all your stress?
Release my stress? Oh, I see what you mean. Being at the top of a mountain really does make someone want to yell out loud. But it's a little uncivilized, isn't it?
It's okay. We're already here, so we should make the best of it. We can chat about whatever you'd like. Yes, they truly are.
Everything about home is filled with purity and passion. My memories of that place are wonderful. I never want to forget them. If I were to ever discard anything so pure, I don't think I'd ever be able to find a place to anchor myself in the vast sea of knowledge. That's why, no matter how tiring or how hard it gets, I won't let my family down. They are already an important part of me.
That's another reason not to lose yourself in the face of pressure.
Yeah. Thank goodness you were there to help me out, or I don't know where I would have ended up. We probably still have a while until the stars come out.
Aw. A moment of respite. I wonder if she's exhausted or if she's finally relaxed. Let's protect this precious moment for just a while longer. Alright, that was pretty sweet. Yes, all the endings are reached. So, that is gonna be it. I have caught up with all the Hangout events. So, thank you guys for watching, and I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.